Hello everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is February 1st, 2019. This is my 38th episode about template meta programming. In this episode, we will learn how to test if a type is an iterator, and we will also learn how to use a function without function body. This method is used a lot by professional C++ programmers. We will be using source code from our previous video, Template Meta Programming 37, Longest Common Subsequence in C++. In this video, click this button, Show More, then click this button to download our previous source code. Click Show in Folder, unzip it, rename the folder, iterator trace 01. Click this folder. Then we don't need these two files. Delete. Now in this folder again, copy this folder. Copy. And paste it to your working folder. Then click folder path, copy the folder path, copy. Then you right click your command prompt, right click, properties. Then starting path, paste. Then click OK. Start Visual Studio Code. Open folder. Paste the folder path. Then enter. Select folder. Click this button. Test iterator CPP. Enter. Control V. Include IO stream. Include iterator. Include talk play pun. Type name H. Namespace talk play pun. Namespace hide int main. Here we will create a function template type name t constant sphere std enable if t true type name std iterator trace t value type. This is function name iterator value type fn t like this. Then we create another function constant sphere talk play fun hide no type dummy. This is dummy type. Actually we don't need this. This type is defined in this file here, no type here, no type dummy. Okay, this is simply struct. In this file again, this is the same function name iterator value type fn. We are using function overloading. This function and these two functions are overloaded. If t is an iterator, this function is enabled and returns the value type. The value type of the iterator type t. If t is not an iterator, then this function is spinned out. Okay, this is catch all function. This is catch all function for this. Using these two functions, we can define iterator type like this. Template, type name t, constex sphere, bool is iterator type b. Then std is the same. No type dummy. DECL type. We are calling this function here. Then we have to provide this type like this, std decl file t like this. Okay, then value. We need to be not. If t is iterator, then this function is defined. This function is defined and returns value type of the iterator. If this function, if t is not type trace, then this function acts and no value type is returned. So we are testing the return value of this function. Value. Like this. Let's check the parentheses once again. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I will explain it here. If t is an iterator, this function returns value type of the iterator. Otherwise, this function no type dummy is returned. If the return value is not equal to no type dummy, then t is an iterator. Otherwise, not an iterator. I hope you understand this concept. Let's try this function. I will copy this function once again here. Please note that this function is namespace hide, so we use like this. I delete this part and I copy here t. We should put hide here. We should prevent hide here like this. Okay, then here I will include the vector for testing purpose. Include vector. Std vector int b. I will initialize this 1, 2, 3. Int a 5. Std cout std bool alpha std cout is v begin an iterator. Then we can test like this. Talk play fun. We are calling this type function std and there. Then here we have to provide type decl type v begin like this. Okay, I copy this function once again, this code once again here. I paste is A an iterator, then we provide A here. A, like this. Then we test this function. I start command prompt. Dir g++ std c++14 test iterator cpp o gexe. I have to do like this. So is the same V doesn't work. Let's see. 126. I need to fix 126. 126. I already defined this function. Yes, I defined for another project. Failure. Now let's build once again. Okay, it works. Now let's examine the code. Here. Is V begin an iterator? True. Is iterator? Is A an iterator? False. A is int type. We need to check another one. Int ptr A. Pointer is also regarded as iterator, like this. Okay. Is ptr an iterator? I put here ptr. Then we build once again. Okay, ptr is also regarded as true, as iterator. If we do not want pointer as iterator, then we can check double time. For example, I can create another function here. And I name it is iterator type excluding pointer B, like this. We can test like this. I use this function T and std is pointer here T value. You can put like this. First, it should be pointer, and it should not be it should be iterator, true, and it should not be pointer. Then let's try this function once again. I copy this again. Is iterator type excluding pointer. Pointer type is not regarded as iterator in this case. And here I can copy it like this. T and hide. Now let's try this function. I copied. No, I will copy the whole part once again. I copied excluding pointer. I will insert this part like this. Like this. And I fix. Copy this. Then paste. Then let's run. So V is V begin an iterator excluding pointer, true, because this is not pointer and is iterator. Is an iterator excluding false. Now this is A is also, A is not an iterator, so false. PTR is now pointer, not an iterator, so false. Okay? I hope you understand this function. If T is an iterator or a pointer, it returns true. Otherwise, returns false. In this case, if T is an iterator and is not a pointer, it returns true. Otherwise, returns false. Now we will add one more function, template, type name T, using iterator value type T, decl type iterator value type fn. We are calling this function std decl bar t like this. Then once, twice, three times. This function, if T is an iterator, it returns T value type. Otherwise, it returns no type dummy, like this. Let's test this function. I will copy this and paste it here. Copy, paste. And hide like this here using V type T. Talk play fun iterator value type T decl type we begin like this using a type t talk play fun iterator value type t decl type a like this. Now we are displaying the type name std cout V type T. We can use talk play fun get type name function. Then we provide type like this std and there. Now we use once again. Now this is type A. Now build. So this type is iterator type, so first element type is int, so this type is int. Since this is iterator, it returns value type int, so int is displayed. In this case, a is int, it is not an iterator, so it returns no type dummy. It returns this function, no type dummy. Okay, let's examine. So a is integer, it's not iterator, it returns no type dummy. In case of v type, this is iterator type, it returns value type of the iterator. So it works successfully. In real program, we need to have three more type functions. I will define one more. Template type name t using enable if iterator t std enable If T is iterator type, T, if it is iterator type, then we return T. Otherwise, it fails. If T is an iterator, this returns T. Otherwise, it is spinned out. Okay, I will copy this function once again. Copy, paste it here. And I will paste once again. T, then hide like this. I need to create another one. Template type name T using enable if iterator value type T. I will change this function enable if iterator type T like this. And I need to change it to, sorry, like this. And here std enable if T. Also, I copy this part. I copied, if it is iterator type, then it is returning value type, iterator value type. Iterator value type T, like this. In this case, if T is an iterator, this returns T's value type. Otherwise, it is spinned out. I copy this function once again. I pasted it here. And I copy this part. T and hide. Another function we need is template type name T using conditional iterator value type T. In this case, type name std conditional is, we are calling this function once again. If this is iterator type, then it returns iterator value. Okay, value type. Otherwise, it returns T like this. I will explain this. If T is an iterator, this returns T value type. Otherwise, it returns t. So this function is very useful actually. I copy this and paste it here. And I copy, paste, delete t and hide. We will test only this function. I copied these two parts once again. Copied, paste. I will name it CV and CA like this. Talk play fun. Conditional iterator type DECL type. B begin like this. Also here I fix. I copy this and paste. Sorry. Copy paste A. Okay. Now CB CA CV CA. Okay, now let's test this function. Okay, G CVA type, something wrong. Now let's check what's the problem. Conditional. Conditional, I need to provide here, build type. Like this. I have to fix like this. Then let's try once again. Okay. Because begin is vector iterator, that's type is element type is int. Then in case of A, this is integral type, integer type, then it returns int. Now I will copy this code to library here, side by side. Then I will copy code from hide in this section, hide section. I copied in here. This is namespace hide. So I will put it here. Paste. Like this. Then I will copy this part up to this point. Copy. Then I will put it here. Then I don't need these these files. I will disable them all. I disabled. Now build once again. Dir. This time let's try with the Microsoft compiler EHSC. SDD. C++ 14 test iterator CPP FE M exe. Okay, and okay, it works. Now GNU compiler, C++, STD, C++ 14. This should be OGEXE. Okay, GNU compiler works. Now clang, CLAN. And I will change it to C. Okay, clang works. This type function is very useful in advanced programming. Here, fix. Today is FPV 02-2019 for additional iterator manipulation. You can use this type library as much as you want. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.